So let's look at these from the top down. First, if P equals NP, would that mean that every computational problem could be solved in polynomial time? Well, no, actually it wouldn't. First of all, there are problems that simply can't be solved, it turns out, which we'll get to later in the course. But even if we restrict ourselves to problems that can actually be solved by a computer, there are still problems that would not be solvable in polynomial time. In fact, we mentioned an example of this in an earlier assignment, where if you wanted to print out all the sublists of a list, then necessarily that means that it will execute in exponential time, not polynomial time, because you have to print out every single possible sublist. And that's a case where the if better construction doesn't actually help you out. So this is not the case. However, the next one is true. If P were not equal to NP, and we proved this, then that would mean that no NP complete problems could be solved in polynomial time. That's, in fact, part of the definition of P not equal to NP. And for the next one, this is also actually true. This is a little tricky and somewhat subjective depending on what you mean by easier here, but it's certainly the case that despite NP complete problems all being, in some sense, as hard as each other, we might care about a certain subset of instances of a problem that, for whatever reason, are easier to solve in practice than another problem might be. And that really depends on what in practice you are concerned about and which instances of a problem that tend to come up in practice. And for the fourth one, this is not true. The ability to solve some instances of an NP-complete problem does not imply that P equals NP. For example, you can find the click or a click or a minimum vertex cover too of an empty graph relatively easily. It's, well, nothing, because the empty graph has no vertices and no edges. That's an example of an instance that you can quite possibly always solve, or you should always be able to solve very quickly. But that doesn't mean that you can solve all instances. And for P equal to NP, we really have to concern ourselves with every single possible instance of a problem. And that's really where NP becomes quite complicated. And finally, showing a problem is NP-complete means it can't be solved in polynomial time? Well, no. In order to do this, we would actually have to show that NP is not in P, or rather, P does not equal NP. That's really the problem we're talking about here in not so many words. So just being NP-complete isn't enough. We also have to prove that P does not equal NP.